coming to Hyderabad for this Telugu film, were you clued into Telugu cinema at all? Like, did you watch any films? Do you have any favorites?
I watched Agadu.
Agadu?
In the cinemas there.
Okay.
Yeah, because I have a few Telugu friends.
Okay.
So they dragged me into that Agadu film and I actually really liked it.
Okay.
I loved it. Yeah, Mahesh Babu. He's my favorite.
Right. So where was Auckland?
Auckland, yeah.
Okay. So what, you've spent your entire life there?
Yeah, basically. I was there when I was 7, so.
Right. So we keep hearing a lot of stuff about New Zealand, but it's literally in the far corner of the earth. So not many people visit it, at least from India, right? So what's life? Probably they just go there to study and settle down there. It's not very few tourists, right?
It's like a tourist place.
It is, but then I don't know if it attracts so many people from India.
Yeah.
Because of the distance factor, maybe, you know.
Yeah.
I'm guessing that's the reason.
Other side. It's so hard for me to travel from there, yeah.
Right. So what's life back home? How's life back home?
It's really nice, clean, quiet. When I come down to India, I just keep hearing noises all the time. When I'm sleeping, I still hear cars going down and past. And when I go there, it's completely silent. Just no sound whatsoever.
Right.
Yeah, it's really small and not many people as well.
Right.
So yeah, I guess it's more of a tourist place, I reckon. Like a lot of people go to the South Island.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what, every time you come down here, do you miss your home a lot because of?
Yeah, and when I go back there, I miss India. So right. That's always there.
Right. So you studied in Auckland, right? So.
Yeah.
What were you dreaming of when you were growing up? Like, what did you want to become?
Actually, I never had a certain thing that I wanted to become. Like, every month it would change.
Every month?
Yeah, like, okay. Sometimes I'll be like, okay, maybe I should try modeling, you know? It looks like a lot of fun. And I'm like, no, I want to become a doctor. No, I want to do this. So, yeah, it's always changing.
Right.
And eventually I decided that I want to do an MBA and work in, like, HR or something like that.
Okay.
But then this came along. Right. So now I'm confused again.
Yeah. Right. But films take longer to make, you know that, right? As in, like, yeah. You can't change your idea of what you want to become every month. Because film itself takes about 3 or 4 months.
Oh, no. I wouldn't change my mind in the middle of a film. Let's see, if I get good projects, then I'll want to pursue this further.
Okay. So what, you've made up your mind to give it another shot for like...
Yeah, of course. Okay.
So how did your family react to this? Because they wouldn't have dreamt that you would act in a Telugu film.
Yeah, no way.
So yeah. Were they pleasantly
surprised?
Maybe
they would have thought Kannada, but Telugu came along, so they were pretty shocked. Like.
Right.
Yeah.
But they're really, really happy. I guess they're the ones who are encouraging the most to pursue further in movies.
Right.
And yeah, they were really shocked and a bit scared as well when I first came to India.
Right.
But then after seeing everything and, you know, the production I was with was really good, so they felt good.
They would have imagined you acting in a Kannada film.
Yeah.
I understand that it's because of your origins, but are you also very clued into Kannada cinema back home as well? Like, do you watch a lot of Kannada films?
I watch the old ones with my family, but okay. I'm not too familiar with the new releases that they have.
Okay, so it's all Rajkumar.
Rajkumar, and all that. Puneet Rajkumar and all.
Puneet Rajkumar, at least from the new lot, right?
Yeah, he is, but he used to act since he was a child, so I've watched his childhood movies.
Right. So, are you thinking of giving it a shot in Kannada cinema anytime soon?
Yeah, I want to.
Okay.
Yeah, because I can speak the language, right? So, I guess it'd be a little bit more easier for me. Yeah, I want to try in all languages, actually.
No, you say you're from New Zealand, so what's the craziest thing that you've done in your life? A lot of people go there to just freak out, bungee jumping, you know, that's the image that the country has, right?
Yeah.
Apart from a lot of touristy, amazing places and all that. So, in that sense, what's the craziest thing that you've done there?
Probably bungee jumping.
Did that?
Yeah.
Okay.
The sky tower.
Skydiving.
Sky tower,
okay.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. You should do it too.
Where is this? Is it in Auckland?
Yeah.
Okay.
You've heard of the sky tower, right?
I think so, yeah, I'm not sure, but I wasn't sure if it's in Auckland or in Christchurch.
It's in
Auckland. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It's not the capital, but
right.
Everything cool is in Auckland.
Is in Auckland?
Like me.
Your family moved from India to New Zealand.
Yeah.
When you were really young, so
seven
years old. So what's your earliest memory in life? Like, do you remember anything about your life
I couldn't speak English.
When you first moved to New Zealand? Okay.
I wasn't really good. So I got bullied like big time at school.
Okay.
My parents just said, like, when you go to school, say, my name's Latha and I can't speak English. And that was probably the worst thing. So, yeah, I had no friends. It was pretty tough. Yeah.
So how long did it take for you to recover from that?
Just a year.
Oh, just a year?
Just a year. Okay. Yeah.
Because you tend to learn really fast then.
Yeah, yeah. When you're a kid, you learn really fast.
Right. Now that first year was horrible, is it? Completely horrible.
Yeah, horrible. I used to cry like every day.
Right. What do you remember from your life back in India before moving there? Were you excited to go to New Zealand in the first place or?
No. I wanted to stay here because I had family and friends here, right? I was just like year two. I think they call it second standard.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I just remember a lot of homework. In New Zealand, we get nothing. Like, we got no homework till I was like 15. We literally had no homework or anything. Over here, it's crazy, the education system.
Right.
They're pretty strict.
That was a good part of studying in New Zealand, obviously.
Yeah, it was good. You get to enjoy your childhood.
Right.
And the studies really just start kicking in till when you're about 15 or 16. So.
And then what happens? You get really serious about it or?
Yeah, like when you get to uni, it gets really tough. Okay. But I guess at that age, you can manage it.
So what's next for you? The film is releasing on March 11th.
Yeah.
Beyond that, are you thinking of something? What are you planning to do next?
Right now, I have no plans as yet. There's a few talks going with me doing future projects, but I'll see if anything works out, then I'll do another film. Or I might pursue my MBA further. That's my plans as for now.
As of now, okay. Yeah. Right. Yeah. But do you have a goal in mind, like 5 years, 10 years down the line, this is what I want to do?
No, I've never been that sort of person to have a goal that far ahead because all these unexpected things always happen to me. Yeah. So I don't plan anything. I was planning, okay, 3 years ahead, I'll do my MBA and then settle. And then this movie came, you know, so no point having a goal.
There's no point having a goal.
Because something always happens.
Such a big statement to make. Right, anyway, thank you so much, Latha. It was a great pleasure talking to you.
You as well.
This is Lavan Tripathi.
Nenu mee Sayataram Tej.
This is Niharika Konnilela.
And don't forget to subscribe to iDream.
Please subscribe to iDream Media.
Please subscribe iDream Media.
Do subscribe to iDream.
Subscribe to iDream Media.
Please subscribe iDream.
Do subscribe to iDream Media.
Don't forget to subscribe. Click on the button below.
Please do subscribe to iDream.
Don't forget to subscribe to iDream.
Please subscribe to iDream Media.